Ba 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 da ba da 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 da.
Hey, bro! Did you get any more yeet? We're running low.
I picked some up from that strange man in the hazmat suit behind the old video rental store.
Ah, Jerry. Good guy. Oh, good. You got the iodized salt, too.
Why did you want it again? We have plenty of regular salt.
All right, check this out. Iodized salt makes you smarter. So I'm gonna eat the whole box and then ace my classes at Hillmark.
Don't think that's exactly how it works.
Nah, I'm pretty sure that's exactly how it works. I did my research. I saw a study that said adding iodine to salt can increase people's IQ scores by over 10 points.
Wait, do you mind if I take a look at that study?
Oh, no, 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 not the music, bro! Don't ruin this for me!
This episode concerns nutritional science, and as always, we recommend you consume in moderation, and speak to your doctor if you have any further questions. And with that out of the way, let's get into it. You may have seen articles that claim that iodine makes us smarter. One such claim comes via Iodeal Brands, a chemical supply company that specializes in iodine derivatives.
Yeah, but like, they make this stuff. Of course they're gonna tell us it's good for us.
Astute observation. Is the claim that iodized salt makes us smarter true? Or is it just some clever marketing to get us to buy something we don't need? First off, iodine is an essential micronutrient our body needs, like vitamins or iron. About 70% of iodine is stored in the thyroid, a small gland located just under your Adam's apple. Iodine is a key precursor to many of the hormones produced in this gland that aid in metabolism, digestion, fertility, and heat production, among other things. Iodine also affects the hippocampus, which deals with emotions and memory, myelin, which helps electrical impulses move along nerves, and neurotransmitters, which transport chemical messages within the brain. The WHO has estimated that close to 30% of the world's population has an inadequate supply of iodine in their diets. Iodine deficiency can lead to goiters, aka enlarged thyroid glands, which can lead to impaired breathing, subtle decreases in IQ, and, in severe cases, a condition called congenital iodine deficiency syndrome. The most severe effects of iodine deficiency are felt in utero, though. It can lead to low birth weight and decreased survival rate. Deficiency in iodine during pregnancy and a child's first 2 years of life can lead to speech, learning, reading, and behavioral disorders. Even mild iodine inadequacy in childhood can lead to reduced intellectual and motor function. In the 1830s, French chemist Jean-Baptiste Boussingault noticed that there was an increased presence of goiters in populations living in places where naturally occurring iodized salt was not frequently consumed, connecting goiters to iodine deficiencies for the first time, and recommended public health interventions to supplement iodine into salt reserves to combat this. Industrial iodization of salt didn't pick up until many years later due to the economic cost and other health concerns. Prior to the 1920s, endemic iodine deficiency was prevalent in the Great Lakes, Appalachian, and Northwest regions of the United States, cheekily being dubbed the Goiter Belt, where 25 to 70% of all children had some level of enlarged thyroid goiter. Michigan physician Simon Levin noticed that of the 583 men he checked for military fitness, 30% had the presence of a goiter that would disqualify them from service. In later years, the Michigan State Department of Public Health determined that the presence of goiter increased to 60% of the population in some parts of the state. The United States didn't begin industrial iodization in salt to combat the prevalence of goiters until 1924, and it worked. However, there was a side effect of iodization that no one predicted. Economists Freyer, Whale, and Politi used military data taken during the draft to determine if there was any geographic correlation to intelligence before and after iodization. They determined that generally, the higher one scored on the military's standardized testing, the more likely they were to be assigned to the Air Force, and those who scored lower would be assigned to the ground forces. They discovered that the men born in the most iodine-deficient areas before 1924 were more likely to be drafted into the ground forces, and men from the same area born after 1924 were more likely to be assigned to the Air Force.
So wait, once iodine was introduced, their test scores went up?
That's what these economists believe. There's been more research on this topic in recent years, too. A meta-analysis of data taken from the Chinese Medical Reference Database, Medline, and Cochrane Library compared the IQs of children born in areas of varying iodine sufficiency in China. Over 12,000 children were included in these studies and found that those living in iodine-sufficient areas had, on average, IQs 9.85 points higher than those living in iodine-deficient areas without supplementation.
So, is iodine actually making people smart then? Was I right, huh?
It's hard to say. This study notes that the intelligence damage of children exposed to severe iodine deficiency was profound, demonstrated by 12.45 IQ points loss, and they recovered 8.7 IQ points with iodine supplementation. The effect of iodine on intelligence isn't so much that it's increasing your IQ, but rather keeping you from losing cognitive function.
Oh, it's like water!
Someone's talking about me.
Drinking water isn't like a magic potion that makes you a superhero. It just makes you not dehydrated.
Yes, it's possible that iodine supplementation is making us smarter, but it's equally possible that we're just seeing what happens when an entire population finally gets enough of an essential nutrient. There are a myriad of pop science articles that make bold claims from this information. Some go as far to claim that iodine is behind the Flynn effect.
The Flynn effect? What's that?
It's the name for the observed increase in IQ scores over time. The titular James Flynn noticed that between 1932 and 1978, IQ scores increased by 13.8 points on average, a 0.3 point increase per year.
So people are getting smarter over time.
Not necessarily. IQ is a bit more specific than just the numerical value of one's intelligence. It's more like the numerical value of one's logic skills, abstract reasoning ability, and working memory capacity. But they're not the only form of intelligence. Someone who scores very low on an IQ test may very well do better in life than one who scored higher. Just because your IQ is higher than someone else's doesn't mean you're smarter than them. In the immortal words of Dr. Stephen Hawking, people who boast about their IQ are losers. Psychologist Eric Turkheimer found that children from higher socioeconomic status expressed more deviations in IQ scoring based on genetic factors, while children from lower socioeconomic status expressed more deviations in IQ scoring based on environmental factors. So, when we consider IQ to be the measurement of one's intelligence, we might actually just be testing whether or not that person had the same opportunities to learn as someone else.
Well, that seems kinda unfair.
It reminds me of my favorite Einstein misquote. If you judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree, it will live its whole life believing that it is stupid. It's easy to see the relationship between iodization and IQ and assume that it's like the movie Limitless, where you just need to take a pill and suddenly you're a genius mastermind. As with most things nutrition, nothing is going to act like a magic potion that suddenly makes you better than you were before. In reality, when we see data like IQ increases, it's more likely that we're removing negative effects than adding a positive effect. For example, if we compare humans who drink water regularly to those who don't, we find a 100% increase in life expectancy. Does that mean that drinking water will make us live longer? No. It just means that if you don't stay hydrated, you'll iodine. Just like what happened to two women who got stuck in an elevator for 4 days. Check out our video on that here.
Oh boy, that was a pretty fun episode, don't you think? If you liked it, be sure to subscribe. Go ahead and ring the like button and smash that bell. Yeah, that's how you say it, right? Smash that bell. Oh, and be sure to let us know your favorite part in the comments below. We'll see you next time.